Let's discuss sutures of the skull. And these, the ones that we're really going to focus on, are associated with the calvaria or the skull cap. Those are the ones that we typically think about. When you say sutures, you sometimes hear that in clinical practice. Sutures, you sew up a wound or something like that. That's exactly where the name came from in terms of these. So you can see in these particular ones, they look like suture patterns or a stitching up of the bones or connection. And that's exactly what sutures are. They're a type of joint. They're fibrous joint, immovable when you're talking about adults, slightly movable when you're talking about juveniles to allow for brain growth. There are four sutures I want you to be familiar with. The first is going to be the more anteriorly placed. It's going to be between your frontal bone, right in the front of your head, and the two parietal bones on the side of your head. This is referred to as the coronal suture. And just for your knowledge, right here in the middle, this is a postmortem hole, so it's not an actual hole that you need to be familiar with. So your coronal suture right here, you hear this term a lot when you're talking about radiology or imaging, when you're talking about a coronal section. So if you think about splitting the body right in half, so you have a front portion and a back portion, an anterior portion and a posterior portion, it gets its name from the suture. So sometimes you'll actually hear this referred to as the frontal suture. The appropriate name is really coronal. Okay, continuing posteriorly, you have a little bit longer suture right in this region. This is your sagittal suture. So between your right and your left parietal bone, so those bones on the side of your skull. So if you've ever heard of a sagittal plane, think of splitting your body right in the middle. You have a right side and a left side. That's where it gets its name from, this sagittal suture. Okay, turning our attentions laterally, you have your temporal bone right here, your parietal bone right here, and this suture right here between the two, between the temporal and the parietal, is your squamous suture. Your squamous suture is different in terms of its structural integrity. It's a little bit more like one plate of bone kind of got smashed up against the other. So it's not quite as suture-like in terms of stitching. It's a little bit more of a bone being placed over another one. So if you were to take apart the temporal bone from the parietal bone, you would see this very prominent portion on the parietal bone. So squamous suture right here. And then lastly, if you're looking posteriorly at the skull, or at the, in this case, we're talking about the cranium, you have your occipital bone and then your two parietal bones. And you can see this suture connecting these three bones right here. This is your lambdoid suture. A lot of times you hear it lambdoidal suture. They're the same thing. This is the most complex of your sutures. And oftentimes you can have small bones, and I'll see if that's the case on this. Yeah, you have one right in this region. You have a little separate bone. These are referred to as sutural bones or wormian bones. These are not pathological. These are just a separate bone in some individuals within a suture. And you have those more likely in your lambdoid suture.